To all those people watching, I like to remind everyone that this video is not made for kids. It's for older fans and adults. Enjoy the fucking video! There was a lot of trackside scrap all over the island, and Sir Charles Topham had decided to have a clean-up. He had heard of a diesel engine fitted with an experimental claw that was up for sale at Swindon, and made an offer to the other railway. The controller of the other railway agreed to the deal, and the new diesel made his way onto Sodor. Hello! What is that? Remarked James.
What's what? That thing on top of you, what is that?
This? Well, this is my claw. The people down at the works in Swindon placed this on me as an experiment, and your Sir Topham Hatt thought it would be useful to help with the trackside scrap cleanup.
Makes you look ugly, replied James rudely.
Before Diesel 10 could say anything else, James puffed away.
Well, he's rude, seethed Diesel 10. I hope the other engines aren't like that.
But he was wrong. As James pulled into the next station, he was talking to Henry about the new diesel. Soon the word had gone round and later everyone started to tease him.
You're not fit to be seen, said Donald.
That claw's such an eyesore.
Indeed.
I agree.
Clank bang bong, teased Thomas.
The other engines laughed except for Diesel 10. He just growled and rolled away.
Silly engines, he grouched.
Soon Sir Charles Topham Hatt put Diesel 10 to work, but he was still bitter about the teasing.
Oh look, it's the diesel potluck!
What an ugly engine!
Shouted James.
I said it before and I'll say it again, not fit to be seen.
Diesel 10 then finally had enough.
If you big-headed engines tease me again, I'll crush you all with this claw. This claw could do a lot more than just pick up scrap, you know.
This made Donald feel very uncomfortable, and he puffed on without saying another bad word to Diesel 10. Diesel 10, however, felt very pleased for what he did, so he decided to do it to each engine as they passed by.
still ugly, replied James bravely.
Diesel 10 growled. Why aren't you scared?
Because you're just making an empty threat, replied James simply. You won't really hurt us, you're weak. You're both ugly and weak, James chortled.
This made Diesel 10 lose his temper. He then started to move fast towards James. James saw this and he began to run away.
I'll show you, weak! Snapped Diesel 10.
But there was trouble ahead.
Oh no!
Cried Diesel 10. His claw had malfunctioned and it couldn't move in time. Luckily, no one was hurt, but Diesel 10 felt very silly. Soon, help had arrived and Sir Charles Topham Hatt came to see Diesel 10. He was not very happy.
Diesel 10, explain this matter.
I've been teased by the other engines, sir, all because of my claw. So I got angry and started to threaten them with it, and James was just the last straw. He called me ugly and weak.
Well, I'll have to speak with my engines later on. But it doesn't mean that you have a right to be a bully back to them. I'll send you to the works, and maybe I'll have to sell you to Croc's scrapyard. They're in need of a new grabber.
But why, sir? Replied Diesel 10 sadly.
Well, after this, what would happen if your claw got jammed by an electrical fault? We can't have you running on our railway with that risk. Croc's scrapyard is really the best option for you, since you won't have any bridges or tunnels to deal with.
I'm sorry, Diesel 10, but it's for the best.
Yes, sir.
When Diesel 10 arrived at the workstation, he was being inspected and looked upon. He was still bitter about the other engines teasing him. Just then he saw a yellow tender engine puffing towards him from the paint shop.
Hello, said the new engine bubbly. My name's Rebecca, and who are you?
They call me Diesel 10.
Diesel 10? How come?
I don't know, probably because I was the 10th Diesel built at Swindon.
Oh, and what happened to your claw?
Then Diesel 10 told Rebecca about his accident.
Well, that is very nice. I think your claw looks amazing.
Amazing?
Yeah! I mean, how many engines have a claw on top? I think that makes you unique and useful as well.
Rebecca's words made Diesel 10 smile for the first time since his arrival. He began to well up with tears.
Oh, I didn't mean to make you cry. Oh no, these are tears of happiness. You are the first engine on this island that has said something nice about my claw for a change. I'm very happy, thank you.
The two engines began talking like old friends. After that, Rebecca puffed away.
Goodbye, Diesel 10. I hope to see you again soon.
Goodbye, friend, replied Diesel 10.
What a nice engine,
he thought happily. He was sad to see Rebecca go, but her kind words would stay in his mind for a long time. Meanwhile, back at the shed, Sir Charles Topham Hatt scolded the engines.
What you all did to Diesel 10 was unacceptable. I will not tolerate bullying on my railway. Just because he's different doesn't mean he isn't useful. If this happens again, I will put you big engines on goods trains, and you, Thomas, will stay in your shed if this keeps up.
Yes, sir, replied the engines, and Rebecca knew that they were sticking to it.
As the years went by, Diesel 10 happily worked at Croc's scrapyard. The other engines didn't tease him anymore, and were apologetic about what they had done whenever they saw him. Then one day, the manager of the scrapyard told Diesel 10 that they had bought a new crane to take over his work, since there had been an increase of scrap metal. But thankfully, the Railway Museum at Vickerstown decided to purchase him, since they, like Rebecca, saw him as unique. Nowadays, Diesel 10 is happily placed on display at the museum with people coming to ask him about his claw. On some occasions, he would do rail tours around the island, but they are most careful whenever they came to a bridge or tunnel. Sometimes, Rebecca would come to the yard delivering coal for the working engines and would always talk to Diesel 10. Diesel 10 loves talking to her,
and although he gets along with the other engines nowadays, he still considers Rebecca to be his first ever true friend.